The next person I would like you to meet is Professor Marcelo Godoy Simões. Hopefully I pronounce your name almost correctly.
Perfect.
And your special area is, translate freely, in particular flexible and smart electric energy systems. Hopefully they are also almost correct. Okay. Right. But let's hear from the professor himself. What on earth are you dealing with? And before I got this job as a host of this event, I was strictly directed to ask you two the most important questions, and they are, where are you from and why are you here?
Okay, it's a pleasure to be here and to participate in this special event. I am originally from Brazil, okay? And I studied and worked in Brazil for several years. I participated at the University of São Paulo as a professor, as a faculty member. And then in the year 2000, I moved to the United States and I joined Colorado School of Mines. It's a small school in Golden, Colorado. It's a school with the mission in energy, and that really allowed me to do a lot of work there for 21 years with the National Renewable Energy Lab, with our program. After that, I traveled around, so I became a Fulbright professor, visiting scholar, and I joined the University of Aalborg in Denmark. I was in France, India, and I taught even in United Arab Emirates. I came to Vaasa, I think that was part of her question, because the research and education here, the capabilities of the electrical engineer department with the FRESI lab, it's our smart grid lab, and the VEBIC research, they are top quality, and we together have a lot of potential to further international recognition.
Great, good to hear. There must be somebody else in the audience and behind the screen, like me, who is not an expert in energy. So can you be a bit more specific and concrete on what is the field of your research?
Sure. My work is in the development of electrical engineering solutions to integrate renewable energy into the utility grid. So in a practical way, we want to have these flexible energy conversion systems to be part of our life. I am working particularly with artificial intelligence and how artificial intelligence could contribute for the modern control of renewable energy integration, and how we can make systems that integrate solar systems, wind turbines, fuel cells with hydrogen, where the hydrogen could be what we call a green fuel coming from sustainable ways, and that would be integrated into the utility grid, to the final users, in standalone systems. So we have a lot of potential here, and I believe we can do a lot, particularly because we have a strong international master in energy. We have the Smart Grid Lab, we call it FRESI, and we have a strong community of researchers and students here who could make a social impact to make the sustainability of our future with our generation in this 21st century.
Right. You mentioned the renewables in your remarks, and well, of course, they are something we need in the future. We need to lower down the emissions and have more renewables. Looking into your work, when would you deem let's say, have success when it comes to renewables? What would be your breakthrough here in Vaasa? What are you searching for?
I have my experience in my vision to what I believe would be important. And I'm working very closely here with many professors, staff, and students, and researchers. We have a plan for the immediate future, and I believe a breakthrough would be to have a working prototype of sustainable energy that would impact our campus, our local communities, so people could see and could perceive what you're doing, and what you're doing is important now and for the future.
Okay, right. Going back to where we started and coming to Vaasa, you mentioned that you have been in the USA for a long time and you originally come from Brazil. So I'm just curious to hear, when was the first time you heard about Vaasa University and its possibilities? And can you, let's say, track down or trace back the moment when that happened, when you saw the light, I will go to Vaasa?
This is a good question, because I'm having for the first time a thought when I thought was a good place to come, and then suddenly it came an invitation. But in 2020 was my last time, my last year at the Colorado School of Mines, where I became emeritus. And in 2021, I was a visiting scholar at the University of Denver. And I was working with the group at the University of Denver because I didn't know what to continue to do with my career. And then I was paying attention to many publications. And I saw there were very interesting publications coming from the group here. I had some friends in Denmark, and I wrote to a few of them if they knew any possibilities in Europe. And then by coincidence, and people say there is no coincidence in our life, he said, well, there is a search going on. That was December 2020. So I wrote to a professor here. We had an interview, we had a search, and eventually I was invited to join, and I'm very happy to be here. So I would say that the first time that caught my attention was about 1.5 years ago.
Okay, right. And then you didn't know anything about the sunny beaches of Vaasa like you have in Brazil.
Okay. I think there is something here that really makes people love Vaasa, you know, the proximity of the ocean, and for sure how the Finnish people are so friendly, how you are so good to us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you for coming here, and we are truly happy to have you in Vaasa. I wish you all the success in your work.
Thank you.
Thank you.